there, I'm Sanaz, and I'm a pilot here at JetBlue. Today I'm going to teach you some of the words that I use every day on the job as a first officer at JetBlue flying an airplane called an A320. Feel free to grab some paper and a pencil. I'll wait. Okay, let's get started with a few different parts of the plane you might see as you are getting on board. The fuselage. The main body of any JetBlue airplane is called the fuselage. The fuselage includes the flight deck, the place where you sit when you fly on us, and the cargo hold.
The cargo hold is where we hold the plane's cargo, all other things the plane is carrying, including your suitcases. Next up, those two arms on both sides of the fuselage, that's an easy one. They're wings. They're part of what makes it possible for the airplane to fly, just like a bird's wings. And those big round things attached to the wings are the engines. Sort of like the engine you might find in a car, but way bigger and way louder. On the back of the plane is the tail fin, which helps keep the airplane balanced in the air. Most airlines use their plane's tail fins to show their flare a little. At JetBlue, we take that to the next level. This one here is my favorite. Okay, review time. The body of the plane is the fuselage. The wings are attached to the fuselage, and the engines are attached to the wings. Together, the wings and the engines make the plane fly. At the back of the plane is the tail fin. Got it? Great! Let's head on board and I'll tell you a few of the words you might hear on the flight deck.
The flight deck is where my captain and I sit when we are flying the airplane. Lots of buttons and levers, huh? A lot of people ask me if planes have keys. The truth is, ours don't. You just need to know which buttons to push. Of course, I can't tell you which buttons those are. You need to become a JetBlue pilot for that one.
Next, let's take a look at how fast we're going. In the sky, we measure speed in knots.
Knots is a tricky word to try and spell. It's K-N-O-T, silent K. Knots are not just how you tie your shoes. They're also how we measure nautical miles per hour. Nautical means related to sailing, but we still use nautical miles in the air.
Another important part of any pilot's toolkit, radar.
This instrument uses radio signals to detect objects around us and tells us how far away they are. There's not a whole lot of stuff we need to watch out for up in the sky, but it's pretty handy for things like other airplanes. Radar is a fun word because it's spelled based on what it means: radio, detecting, and ranging. Now that we know how to measure how fast our plane is going and can tell if there's anything we need to steer around, how do we make it move? These thrust levers or throttles control how fast or slow a plane can fly. When we move the throttles, the plane moves. Kind of like the gas pedal on a car. We also have to be able to steer the plane left and right. For that, we use a tiller and rudder pedals. The tiller controls the front wheel of the plane, called the nose wheel, and helps us to steer while we are on the ground. The rudder pedals also help control the nose wheel while we are on the ground, and they control a movable flat piece at the back of the plane that helps us to steer while we are in the air.
When we are in the air, we have two more ways of controlling the plane.
First up, the control stick. Whoever named this thing did a great job. It's a stick that helps us control the plane during the flight. All of our planes either have a control stick or another tool called a yoke. Another word with tricky spelling. Sounds like egg yolk, but it's spelled Y-O-K-E, and it does not come with bacon. Basically, it's a steering wheel for the plane. So now you know some of the words you might hear on the flight deck. During a flight, my captain and I use the throttle, rudder pedals, tiller, control stick or yoke to control the plane. Together, these tools help us to steer the plane and control how fast we are going. We measure our speed in knots and use our radar systems to figure out where we're going and if there are any obstacles in our way. Let's talk through some of the terms we use while doing my favorite thing, flying.
The first part of any flight is taxiing the airplane over to the runway. Taxiing is when an airplane slowly moves across the ground to take you from the airport terminal to the runway and back again. When you hear the word runway, you might imagine fashion shows, but it's also what we call the path we use to take off or land airplanes. Climb is what we call it, and an airplane rises little by little until we get to the height we want. When we are flying, we call height altitude. Altitude is the measurement of how high up we are from sea level. When we reach the right altitude, we try to stay there for most of the flight at a nice steady speed. When you hear an announcement during a flight that the plane has reached cruising altitude, this is what we are talking about. Usually cruising altitude for one of our flights is around 36,000 feet, almost 7 miles high. A headwind means that we are flying in the opposite direction that the wind is moving. It can really slow us down and makes us use more fuel than we normally do. On the other hand, a tailwind means that we're flying in the same direction as the wind, which can make us go a lot faster, sometimes up to 800 miles per hour. Descent is the part of the flight where we slowly lower the plane's altitude and prepare to land back on the ground. Okay, let's talk through all the words we just learned one more time. The first part of any flight is taxiing the plane onto the runway. Once we are clear for takeoff, we will climb to our cruise altitude. Throughout the flight, we are navigating based on longitude and latitude and accounting for any headwind or tailwind we might be dealing with. Once we reach our destination, we start our descent. This is your first officer speaking. We have officially reached the end of today's lesson. Hope you enjoyed learning some of new words to use the next time you fly with us. Thank you for joining me. My name is Sanaa, and from all of us at JetBlue, we hope to see you in the air soon.